Hey everyone, and welcome to episode 13 of my Let's Build a Medieval Village series. In this episode, I'll be showing you how to build this boathouse in the fishing area. It has plenty of storage, a few workstations, and even a little custom fishing boat inside. In the next episode, I'd like to build in the middle district, so be sure to leave your request for what you'd like to see me build there in the comments section. As always, the most popular requests will then be put into a poll, where you can then decide on a winner which will be featured in the next episode. So I really hope you enjoy the video, like the build, and have fun building this in your own worlds. To start, I'm just marking out a rough boundary by coming across diagonally where the corner of the wall is. After that, I'm removing the first layer of ground within the fishing area, and I'm replacing this with a random mix of cobblestone, stone, stone bricks, and andesite. You could also add in some cracked or mossy stone bricks too, for a bit of extra detail. If you'd like to save on resources, you can skip replacing the ground here by the sea, as we're going to build on top of this anyway. And at the end, I've just added a bit of a border at the sides to replace the sand here. So, here's the location of where the boathouse will be built, right on the edge of the fishing area. And here's the outline of the build. The shorter sections are 3 blocks across, and the longer sections are 7 blocks across. Then we have 2 blocks coming across in each of the corners here. And here you can see that the build will be right on the edge of the fishing area, with the oak logs going down into the sea to look a bit like supports. So, to start, at the front bring up the log on the left by 5 blocks, so it's 6 blocks tall in total. Then bring up the log on the right by 7 blocks, so it's 8 blocks tall in total. And in the middle, add a mix of 4 oak planks and stripped oak logs on each side, leaving a gap in the centre like this. Now, in this gap, add an oak stair at the bottom and top like this. Then add in a couple of spruce fences and some oak leaves along the bottom. After that, in front and to the side of the log on the left, add an extra log with a spruce stair on top, just like this. Now repeat all of this again on the right hand side too. It's exactly the same, just mirrored. So the column on the left is 8 blocks tall in total, and the one on the right is 6 blocks tall in total. After you've done that, come round to the corner and add 4 mixed oak blocks in each of the 2 block gaps, with a 5 block tall column in the middle and on the right, like this. And finish off the corner by adding an extra oak log with a spruce stair on top on either side of the right hand column, and some oak leaves between the inner logs. Now, on this side, make the column on the right 5 blocks tall. Then add 4 mixed oak blocks along the outline with a gap in between each set to create 3 window spaces. After that, in these window spaces, add an oak stair at the top and bottom with spruce fences in the middle. Now, on the right, I'm just going to add a few more stone blocks so I can place the extra oak logs with the spruce stair on top on each side of the column. Then finish this side off by adding some oak leaves along the bottom. At the next corner, this is the same as what we did at the front. So make the middle oak log 5 blocks tall and the column on the right 6 blocks tall. Then fill in the 2 block wide spaces with a mix of oak blocks. And finish by adding in some oak leaves at the bottom. The section at the back is very similar to the front. So we have the 6 block tall column on the left and an 8 block tall column next to this with a window in the middle. Now, where it changes is at the bottom. Here, add 2 oak logs sticking out, in line with the stone floor, like this. Do this on both sides. Now, in front of the stone, add 2 rows of spruce slabs to fill this gap in, like this. On top of the first row, add some oak leaves. Then add spruce slabs on top of the first oak log that sticks out, and place upside down spruce stairs below them. And add a spruce button on the end of the logs for a bit of extra detail. After that, come round to the left side and add 1 log sticking out in line with the others with a spruce button on the end. Now, come over to the other side and do all of this again. It's exactly the same, just mirrored. Thank you. When you've done that, under the water where the logs are, I've just removed some of the sand going across. Then I'm replacing the sand in between the logs with some mixed stone blocks and adding a few extra logs below what we already have so they look a bit more like supports. Now, this next section is exactly the same as what we did on the other side. So fill in the corner here and add the oak leaves and extra oak logs at the bottom for a bit more detail. If you have to build up the ground a bit here, then that's fine. On the longer side, make the column 5 blocks tall in total, then mark out 3 window spaces. And finish by adding in the extra logs and oak leaves. Then fill in the last corner to complete this part of the build. And here's what you should have so far. Now, at the front, add some mixed stone stairs in front of the middle oak logs, like this, with the outer stairs facing to the side. After that, come inside the build and start filling in the floor, again using mixed stone blocks. We're going to leave a gap in the middle starting at the back. This will be in line with the 2 oak logs, going back by 8 blocks. And here you can see a better view of where the gap will be. So it's 8 blocks across and 7 blocks wide. When you've done that, in the gap, add any stone block next to the log, followed by 6 mixed stone stairs after this. In the corner, add another block, like this, with a stair next to it facing to the side. After that, remove the block behind the stair, followed by the 4 next to it, like this. Then add more mixed stone stairs, following the outline of the gap, making sure that all of the stairs connect to each other. Now do the exact same on the other side too, to complete the border. So the floor inside the build should look like this. We're now going to remove the ground inside this gap so it lines up with the sand from the sea. For me, this is 3 blocks down. I've also added 3 more stairs at the back of this gap between the stone blocks. And finally, I'm replacing all of the sand inside this space with mixed stone blocks and filling in the water so it's in line with the sea. So you should now have this. When you've done all of that, come back outside. At the front, on the left, add 2 oak logs sticking out of the top log, like this. Then add a spruce stair below them with a spruce button at the end. And repeat this again on the next column, making sure it's in line with the logs on the left. Then, on top of the window, add 3 more mixed oak blocks, like this. Now do the exact same on the right-hand side too. After that, in the middle, add spruce planks going all the way across, 1 block above the logs that stick out. Below this, add another plank on each side. Then add a stair below these planks with a spruce slab next to them. And for some extra detail, add a spruce trapdoor below all of the upside down stairs. Now, in front of the extra oak blocks that we added, add an upside down spruce stair on each side with a spruce slab in the middle. Do this on both sides. Then come round to the side and add the logs that stick out again. And repeat on the other side too. Now, on the side that sticks out, add the two oak logs again on the top oak log, so they're one block lower than the ones at the front section, like this. We aren't adding the spruce trapdoor below the stair here. And repeat this on the next side of the log, as well as the log on the other side of the wall. Then, come round to the other side and do the same again. And at the back, we're going to do the same as we did at the front with the logs that stick out. Now, above the windows, add the extra mixed oak blocks again. Then add the spruce stairs with the slab in the middle in front of them. When you've done that, in the middle, add an upside down spruce stair in line with the logs that stick out on each side. And above these, add spruce planks going all the way across. Then add spruce trapdoors in front of and below the spruce stairs, like this. Now we're going to start work on the roof outlines. So, starting at the front, add a dark oak slab in the corner, like this. Then add another on top of the log, followed by two blocks made using slabs, with one more slab at the end. After that, add another slab with one more sticking out so you're in line with the column. Then add two stairs with upside down stairs on the back of them, with one more stair at the top to finish off this side. Now, come over to the other side and do the exact same thing again. There's a graphic on screen to help you if you get stuck. When you've done that, in the gap at the top, add an upside down stair to fill it in. Then add a stair on top of this, with an upside down stair on the back of it, so it sticks out just like this. To fill in the gap below the roof outline, add alternating spruce and strip spruce logs on top of the spruce blocks that we added, just like this. So you should have this so far. Now, in the middle, add a spruce slab on top of the first log that sticks out. After that, add an upside down spruce stair followed by four slabs, then another upside down stair. To decorate this ledge, I'm just adding a couple of flower pots with flowers or bushes in them. Now, in the middle, add a spruce fence, followed by a fence gate, then another fence like this. You need to crouch to be able to place the second fence. Below this fence, add a chain and then a spruce plank. Now, surround the plank with glow item frames and add in some boats. And finish by adding a spruce trapdoor below the plank. Then add a lantern on each side of the build to light up the area a bit. Now come round to the back and do the same again. There's a graphic on screen to help you with the roof outline, or you can look back in the video to where I took you through it step by step if you get stuck. When you've done that, in the middle, add the upside down stair on each side with the slabs in between. Then add the extra slab on top of the log that sticks out. After that, decorate with a flower pot, then create the sign with the boats on it again, just like we did at the front. Then finish this side off by hanging up a couple of lanterns. Now come round to the side. For this roof outline, start by adding a dark oak slab in the corner, followed by a second on top of the log. Then add a block, followed by a slab next to this. On top of the slab, add a stair with an upside down stair on the back of it, with one more at the top to finish off this side. Now do the same on the other side too. There's a graphic on screen to help you with this. In the middle, add an upside down stair with another on top and an upside down stair on the back of that, just like we did on the other roof outlines. Now, at the top of the windows, add an upside down spruce stair on each side like this. Then add spruce trapdoors going all the way across between these. And fill in the gap above them with alternating spruce and strip spruce logs. You'll have to crouch to be able to place these. So the side should now look like this. When you've done that, carry on the bottom dark oak slab so it goes across to the wall like this. Do this on both sides. After that, add a spruce slab, a dark oak slab, then another spruce slab like this. Repeat this for each layer of the roof outline to fill this part of the roof in, starting with slabs, then using stairs. And when you get to the top, add a row of dark oak slabs like this. Then do the exact same on the other side too. And when you've done that, come over to the other side and do the same again. There's a graphic on screen to help you if you get stuck, or you can look back in the video to where I took you through it step by step. Now, behind this, add the larger roof outline again. The bottom slab is already in place for this from the roof outlines we've already done. Again, there's a graphic on screen to help you if you get stuck. When you've done that, in the corner, add an upside down stair on the right, next to the slab, with two more on the left behind the slabs, like this. Then come round to the other side and do the same again. To fill in the gap here, we're going to use alternating spruce and strip spruce logs again. To save on resources, you can add some slabs that you can place the logs on, like this, as anything lower than this won't be seen anyway. Then carry on adding the alternating logs to fill this gap in. And once you're done, it should look like this. Now come round to the other side and do all of this again. Thank you. And when all of that's done, we can start filling in the roof. So to do this, come to the bottom corner and add spruce slabs following it round, like this. Repeat this for all of the layers, starting with slabs, then using stairs. And when you get to the top, use dark oak slabs going all the way across. When you've filled this section in, for a bit of extra detail, count across by two blocks and remove the third one, going down in a line on both sides like this. Then fill in this gap with dark oak stairs and slabs just like this. And to make the roof look a bit more worn, I'm just replacing some of the stairs with planks and adding another slab or two on top of the slabs as well. Then I'm doing the same on the side roof to make this look a bit worn too. Now fill in the next three roof sections in the exact same way. If you get stuck at any point, feel free to look back in the video. When you've filled in the roof, at the side, add an extra couple of dark oak slabs on the top, like this. Then do the same across the top of the main roof. When you get to the very centre, add a plank. Then continue to add the slabs across the other three sides. So you should now have this. Don't forget to add the extra slabs on top of the other small section of roof too. When you've finished off the roof, come inside the build. In here, head over to the left-hand side and add spruce slabs going across in the space here. Make sure to add a torch in the space above this so nothing can spawn. Now, half a block up, add another row of slabs going across like this. Then add a second row directly in front of them. After that, on the right, add an extra three slabs so they go across diagonally like this. Then hang up a lantern and do the same on the left side too. Now, turn around and we're going to repeat everything that we've just done on this side too. So start with the slabs in between the oak planks with a torch in the space above it. Then add two rows of slabs half a block up from this. After that, add the three extra slabs in each corner and hang up the lanterns. Now, on the left and right, add an extra slab like this. Then, add another row of slabs going across half a block up from what we already have. After that, add more slabs coming across diagonally, just like this. Make sure to remove any that you added to help you place these. On the other side, do the same again, but add a trapdoor at the end instead of a slab, like this. and filling the gap behind the trapdoor with an extra slab. Then add another row half a block up again. And after that, add another row in front of what we've just added. Then in front of this, add 5 slabs coming across on the right and left. And finally, in front of these slabs, add 4 more coming across, just like this. Then just add a few torches to the space above to make sure nothing can spawn. Now turn around and do the exact same on the other side too. It's quite complicated, so feel free to look back in the video if you get stuck at any point. When both sides are done, it should look like this. Now all we have to do is fill in the gap with slabs that are half a block up again and add some more torches to light up the space above. And that's the roof completed. We can now start work on the interior of the build. So to start, we're going to build a small boat in the water in the middle. To do this, 4 blocks away from the side, add a spruce plank. On top of this plank, add 3 spruce slabs, like this, then remove the plank. On top of these slabs, add another 3 with 1 extra at each end, like this. If there's any gaps in the water, just use a water bucket to fill these in. Now, at the end, use a temporary block to place an upside down stair like this. Then add a trapdoor on top of this with a slab in front. You'll have to crouch to be able to place the slab. And repeat this on the other side too. Now, in the middle, add a stair, leave 2 blocks and add another to make 2 seats. After that, use temporary blocks to place trapdoors in front and next to the stairs we've just placed, like this. Skip the middle block for the moment. When you've done that, add a barrel in the middle and place a spruce sign on either side of this. Again, you'll have to crouch to do this. Now, on top of the barrel, add 3 spruce fences. On either side of the top fence, add a fence gate, like this. Then add spruce trapdoors across the top and place 3 white banners going across the front. And that's the boat completed. Now, on each side of the gap, add a spruce fence with fence gates going all the way across, like this. Do this on both sides. After that, at the side, make a table using upside down spruce stairs and slabs, just like this. Then decorate this with an item frame and a couple of flower pots like this. And in each corner, add some randomly stacked barrels and chests with a crafting table too. Then do the exact same in the opposite corner to finish this side off. And finish off the build by doing the exact same on the other side, but add a loom instead of a crafting table here. And that's the boathouse completed. You can also add some extra barrels outside for some more decoration if you want to. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you liked the build and enjoyed the tutorial. Remember to leave your build requests in the comments for what you'd like to see me build in the Middle District. Thank you again for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next episode.